this is the first time I came over here, but I'm following your movement from last 2 years continuously, and I wish all the best to Aam Aadmi Party that it wins the Delhi elections for sure. I also wish that at least minimum, if Aam Aadmi Party targets around 100 seats for the parliamentary elections of 2014, it will spoil the game of all the corrupt leaders of either the BJP or the Congress, that's what I think. Because without you, they won't have any bill which can be passed in the parliament or like that. Because I can't say that on the all constituencies the Aam Aadmi Party will win or like lose. But try to focus on the constituencies where the corrupt candidates or where the goons are fighting the elections and which are already like around 162 are there. In the Lok Sabha, that's according to the figure, who has a rape cases, who has criminal cases. So a good person can be deployed from the Aam Aadmi Party in each of these constituencies. That's what my suggestion is. Regarding, sir, your centralization thing about the decentralization given more at the local level, I would just like to suggest, like recently I was in India for the last 1 year, and I come from the Gujarat state, where the BJP has won quite heavily in the local elections. But what I have noticed is most of them are the goons who are like fighting the elections at the local levels, like in the councils and everywhere. So like if you give more powers at the local level, right now rampant corruption is going on in Gujarat, but it's not coming out. And regarding Mr. Modi, as everyone knows, he's a highly publicized person. The real image is not putting out around the globe, and it's a wrong image has come out, because there's a lot of malnutrition, there are a lot of issues, and in terms of human development index, Gujarat is quite lacking behind. And Gujarat was prosperous from the day, like long time back. It's not within the Modi era it has come up. So it's just a marketing cue which you all know. So regarding the decentralization at the local level, I feel that at the moment, till you handle the reign power in the center, it should be centralized, that's what I suppose, and gradually when the reforms comes and all the good people comes in the parliament, then it should be decentralized gradually.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Can we have one more question there? The gentleman who raised his hand.
Hello, Prashanti.
Hello.
Yeah, hi.
I see most of
your
the
introduction.
So, I mean, say, I am one of the active party members.
Do you mind holding up the mic?
Yeah, I'm one of the active party members with Aam Aadmi Party UK, and I was involved in the anti-corruption movement from another. So basically the question what I have is, most of the time we find like when the parties fight the elections, they come up with some free lunches. Most of the time you can see, like we'll give laptops, we'll give all these kind of things, like the students will give. So, are you planning any kind of stuff?
No,
I don't think so.
No, we don't have money for own laptops. We don't have money for own laptops.
So, is it like something which is useful to the public, general public? Because we can see, like in Tamil Nadu, they give like mixed seeds.
No way.
Basically, it comes from the public only. Nobody can give.
The other question is, like at any point in time, would you have a coalition with other like-minded parties? Because like we know, like we had seen all the time, we have a coalition governments for last few, almost last 10-20 years.
No, you should have enough propaganda. Take
your
vote for
that.
Can you please say your name and where you from?
Yeah, my name is Hemant, and
can you stand up?
South Hall mein rehta hun.
This is Hemant's college.
I'm very happy you're here. मैं इनका आंसर देना चाहूंगा कि अगर कोई राहत और रिलीफ की बात करें जो कि फ्री में है, अवेलेबल है और सबको फायदा होगा, क्योंकि हर आदमी तंग है आज के दिन में. मतलब आम आदमी नहीं अफोर्ड कर पा रहा, मतलब हर चीज, रोटी, कपड़ा, मकान, जो बेसिक कॉस्ट है ना. इंडिया में हम कभी जाते हैं तो अब लगता है कि यहाँ से भी फ्लाइट महंगी है, जो ट्रांसपोर्ट है वो यहाँ से महंगा है. यहाँ पे बार्गेन हो जाता है, यहाँ पे 1 pound में भी बस की टिकट मिल जाती है, बट अगर वहां पे जाना हो तो धक्के खा के भी ना उतने पैसे में अफोर्ड नहीं होता. Forget about quality. कुछ रिलीफ की बात अगर करी जाए तो सबके हित में होगी, जो कि सुविधा को और जो सिस्टम को सुधार के मिल सकती है लोगों को.
बिल्कुल आप ठीक कह रहे हैं. See, we have to see, we have to say that we are promising you something far, far, far more than a laptop or a mixing. We are promising you a corruption-free government, which will, and not only that, we are promising you that these officials will be made accountable directly to you. They will, if you want to remove a local official, you will have the power to do so. So therefore, they will not be able to thereafter act roughshod over the people. That bijli, pani, other essential commodities will be available to you at a reasonable price. You will not be looted in all these things. You will get your ration properly without having to bribe anybody and so on. So therefore, what you will get if you vote for the Aam Aadmi Party is much more than a laptop. Decentralization. There are problems with decentralization. We understand and we realize that. One problem that is associated with decentralization is that, well, if you allow the people of a village to take all the decisions of that village themselves, then there may be some particular groups in that village who will ride roughshod over the others, or who will, or they may be majoritarianism, minority interests may be trampled upon. You see, Raja Bhaiya will not be able to, because when everybody, when things are being decided by vote, of course, Raja Bhaiya, etc., will have to be controlled by other means. But when everything is being decided by secret ballot or by vote, which can be by secret ballot also, then all that you have to ensure is that people are able to vote freely. If they are able to vote freely, they will vote for whatever they want. Raja Bhaiya cannot influence their vote. But what can happen is, in some cases, what can happen is that there may be a numerical majority in some place which may want to appropriate everything for themselves. If there is a caste, let's say, which is in a numerical majority, and if everything is decided by majority there, then this majority can say, all right, all the school would be built here, the admissions would be of only our children and so on. So you need to have some way of protecting minority rights and ensuring, of course, that is protected by the Constitution. The Constitution itself protects minority rights. Somebody was asking this morning when I was giving a talk at Oxford that if you allow too much decentralization, why would you not allow secession of different states to secede from the Union? So my answer was that the thing that binds the Indian Union, India is of course a very diverse country, has all kinds of people with all kinds of different likes and dislikes, etc. And therefore, in a country like India, it is even more important, in a diverse country like India, it's even more important that there should be decentralization of power, that different people should be allowed to do the things that they want, provided they do not run foul of the Constitution and its principles. Our Constitution is an excellent Constitution in general, which lays down very sound principles of fundamental rights, minority rights, non-discrimination, etc. That's really what binds the Union. Everybody in this Indian Union has to subscribe to the principles of the Constitution. But within those principles, they can do whatever they want. If some area wants to, if some village wants to spend all their money on schools, they should be able to. Another village wants to spend all their money on roads, they should be able to. whatever they want, whatever their local needs, requirements are, they should be able to do that. So therefore, decentralization is fine, but you have to take care of these, that within that decentralization, constitutional principles are not sacrificed. The constitutional principles of non-discrimination, minority rights, etc., have to be adhered to even while everybody, every region, every village is free to pursue whatever else they want, but within the framework of the constitution.
Thank you.
Thank you. So, coalition, there was one other question.
Yes.
Coalition.
No
way. You see, we are not interested in
power,
office or government. We don't, even if we get 100 seats in parliament, we would be in the driver's seat. We may not form the government, we are not interested in forming the government. But we will be able to dictate our agenda to whichever party forms the government. We will offer outside support in that case to that party or that coalition which promises and delivers on that promise of our democracy reforms, electoral reforms, institutional reforms, Lokpal Bill, etc. Whoever is willing to deliver on those promises, we will support. Because even if they are corrupt in their government, once they bring the Lokpal Bill, they will all get caught. So therefore, we will say, because nobody else will be able to form the government without our support if we get 100 seats. So therefore, if we get 100 seats, then we will be able to dictate our agenda in parliament.